Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how to measure distance and area using Google Maps on your computer, so check it out. Hey everyone, it's Ken here from Northern Viking Everyday, and if you are new to this channel, it is all about reviews and how-tos, so make sure you click that subscribe button so you don't miss out on upcoming videos. Today I'm going to show you how to measure distance and area using Google Maps on your computer. It's really easy to do and free, so let's head on over to my desktop and show you how to do this. All right, so we have Google Maps loaded up here in our web, and first off, I took the liberty of loading up Central Park in New York. So we're going to just do some measurements here in Central Park. And first off, we're just going to measure one side, and then we'll show you how to measure the area. I've got it in the regular kind of drawn mode, but you can also do this in the satellite mode if you like. But we'll do it in the drawn mode, or the map mode, I guess you might call it. So first off, you just find a point that you want to start measuring. So we're going to take this bottom left-hand corner, and we are just going to right-click. And at the bottom, there's a little menu that pops up. It says measure distance. So we're going to click on measure distance. And then we are going to find the other corner that we want to measure to. And then we're just going to hit left click. And you can see in the bottom there, a little window pops up. And it says total distance 832.58 meters or 2,731 feet for the one side there. So It automatically measures that side for you, puts the distance there at the bottom. So that's how you measure one side as a distance. Now we're going to go ahead and do the area. So we're going to find the next point that we want to measure. And we're going to click this top corner, right-hand corner here. Just left-click on that. And you can see another line was added. We're going to pick the other corner here. We're going to just left-click on that. And then we are going to come back down to where we started and left click on the point that we started on. And you can see that it drew a perimeter around the whole park. And let's scroll in and see what they say the size is here. 3.44 kilometers squared or 1.33 miles squared. So I took the liberty of Googling how big this park is so we can just compare. I know it might not be 100% accurate because we just did a really rough estimate, but Google says it's 3.41 kilometers squared, and this says 3.44 kilometers. So we're really close. That's quite amazing, actually. So the other thing I wanted to show you is doing this in satellite mode. So you can see when you click over to satellite mode, the perimeter still stays up there, the white line. If you just right click, you can hit clear measurement, and that measurement will disappear. You might want to do it in satellite mode sometimes. Maybe you, for instance, here in the park, there's a whole bunch of baseball diamonds. And if you're in map mode, those baseball diamonds don't really show up well. But maybe you want to know the distance from this baseball diamond to this baseball diamond. So that's when a better time probably to use the satellite mode. So again, if you just want the distance, right click, measure distance, and then left click, and it'll show you the distance there. So sometimes it's nice to use it in satellite mode, and that is 152.12 meters or 499 feet. And it is that simple. So I hope this little tutorial on how to measure area and distance in Google Maps helped you out. If it did, make sure to smash that like button. Also remember to subscribe to Northern Viking Every Day because I've got tons of videos coming up that I would love to share with you. Thanks for watching today and take care.